3529.
Yep.
Marilyn Cole. MARILYN.
Okay.
Austin, Florida.
Okay.
34669.
All right. Yeah, what's crazy was, I don't know, did you get a Facebook message from this girl, Whitney? The friend request says, what's so crazy, it's crazy that I got your letter and everything, because I saw that you put money on my account, and I was just saying to this girl, I was like, dude, I wonder if I could get a hold of him somehow, or whatever, right, because I didn't remember your number, it was in my phone, but I didn't remember it. And then I was like, and I know he was in Florida, and I was like, dude, I need you, because this chick just got out on drug court, and I was like, I need you to go on Facebook and look up my dad. And she was like, what's his name? And I was like, all right. And I told her, and she just sent it last night, sent you a Facebook message or whatever, asking for your number and your address so I could write you and call you. And then I got your letter today, and I was like, that's crazy.
I don't think she did.
All right.
She found an old Facebook and not the one.
Right.
Because I have like two or three of them.
Yeah.
At least two that I know of that are, you know, when you punch my name, I still come up.
Yeah.
She has
like a million.
Right, exactly like that. And plus, I don't know, a lot of my because I'm getting so many requests from people trying to
talk to you.
All the stupid news people.
I got a letter from WMUR from Amy Covino asking for an interview. I got a letter from someone from where is it? Illinois or Indiana, something like that, asking me questions. I'm like, are you kidding me? Like, leave me the fuck alone, dude.
Right.
And then if I get out on Thursday, I know these people are gonna be standing out. Like, it's gonna be on the news because I'm on the news every time. So I know my course is on news. It's gonna be, oh, she's getting released. They're gonna be outside the jail and everything. They were banging outside my window when I first got here. I was over on the window on like Willow Street side, on the bottom floor on the top. They came with my window and everything, were banging and everything. I was like, what the f***, dude?
Really?
Yeah, they had to move me. I wrote you a letter, but I'm going to mail it out tonight, and I'll send the pictures with it of the kid.
Yeah, and, let me know if they need anything out there, if you need something specific, something I can get for them, I need something to help out, I don't know how your mother's situation is, but, just let me know if there's anything I could do.
Yeah, I will. I know, I just found out that my Uncle Todd passed away 2 Fridays ago, and my aunt, they was in Manchester, they was on 2nd Street, or South Main Street, they was on South Main Street, like right down the house from Guilford, right down the street from Guilford Street, they was like right there, and he just passed away. He was a veteran and everything, but he was like overweight and had so many health issues, but he just passed away. He got cremated and everything, and now my aunt's living at my grandma's house up north because she was, like, everything got shut off the day that he died, so she has, like, nothing right now. And they were coming down every weekend to help my mom and everything with the kids, but I'll let my mom know to let me know if she needs anything or whatever, and I'll put her number in the letter so you have her number.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you could somehow stay in contact.
Yeah.
Because I tried reaching out to you regardless of whatever was going on, the diet, the only checking not getting fucking along or whatever that is.
Yeah,
I kind of just leave them to the fucking,
to deal with their own shit,
their own fighting and all these deaths and
stuff. Yeah.
You know what I mean? So I don't bother getting involved. I mean, you guys were kind of closer than me and Adam were just because of the simple fact that I was gone for so long.
Yeah.
So you guys have your own relationship. I just say the fuck out of it, And whatever. It's like I don't take sides. Kevin's my brother.
Yeah.
I love you both with that child amongst
books, and then Adam was freaking out. Oh, he was being crazy. That's why I had to leave. That's why I separated myself from him. He was being crazy.
Yeah, I know. I talked to him a little bit.
Yeah, I had to go. I couldn't do it. But, I love him.
Like,
I just, I don't know. I still love him. I'm here for him. I miss him. I'm not going anywhere. Like, if you can let him know that, like, I'm still here.
Okay.
I'm not going nowhere.
I'll talk to him. He should be calling me here any day. I haven't heard from him.
Yeah.
In a few days. And, you know, he's trying to hang in there. And,
yeah.
You know,
I know he misses the kids too. That's why I was trying to ask the ladies to send pictures, like make sure he gets pictures and stuff, because I know he'll appreciate it and everything. And she told me that her husband will send a picture, so I don't know what he got, but I'll definitely send you pictures when I send out the mail tonight.
And if whatever I get, I'll make copies of and send back to him so he don't get anything.
Right, they're all black and white off because they just make photocopies of everything. They make photocopies of everything now and just give it to you.
Did you even know we had twins down here?
No.
Oh, yeah.
A twin?
Yeah, it's twins.
Would you get another one? Would you have more?
Well, you know, she was pregnant with Bailey when we came up there, right?
Yeah,
She turned 3 in December.
Wow.
And the twins are going to be 2 in July.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah. Well,
congratulations. That's crazy.
A boy and a girl twin combination.
Wow.
Bring in Brendan. Yeah.
Wow.
I'll get some stuff together and send you these guys.
Yeah.
You see how small Bentley was? I mean, he's ripping around on the dirt right now.
Really?
Yeah, you should see it. I'll send you some pictures. He's doing motocross and shit, so he's jumping.
Oh, wow.
Yeah,
that's awesome. That's awesome.
I'll get some stuff together for you and get it out here within the next couple of days.
Alright.
I'll get you some pictures. I'll get it together, but I'll wait till Thursday to see what happens before.
Yeah, exactly, yeah.
You know, hopefully we didn't let
you
moving on.
So. And now, the other thing too, my lawyer was like, oh, you need to, like, tell me I need an address. I'm like, dude, people, because I can't go to mom's house because she has the kids. So, DCY has to make a big deal about me going to mom's house with her having the kids. So I'm like, well, I can't because of the substance use or whatever, which I understand that, so I have to find somewhere to go. I can't go to my aunt's house now because my uncle is passed and she doesn't have a place no more. And then the lady, Angie from church, she was like, well, we can't really have anybody in her house. And I'm like, well, I wasn't expecting you to say yeah anyways. I was just asking just so I could find somewhere to go until I can get a place, because I know I'd be able to figure out something, you know what I mean? And I'm like, well, can't I just go to the shelter until I, like, get a place to go, like, so, I don't know, they're just trying, they just want to know where I am at all times, you know what I mean, so it's going to be hard to see, like, I just know they're going to give me a ridiculous bail just to keep me here.
1 minute,
remaining. So just go to
the program still.
I know, that's what I want to do, that's what I'm trying to do, I need my lawyer to call.
I don't know if y'all, but they kind of let you out of state or whatever.
Yeah, no,
that's
me, yeah.
If it's an option, give my address, but they're on the clinic.
Yeah, I know.
All that is, you just can't help and leave, but if it's the worst case scenario, you know, you need it to be an option, just let me know.
Yeah, I'll figure it out. So we'll see what happens on Thursday.
Alright.
And then I'll talk to you, I don't know when I'll be back here, if I come back here, but we'll see what happens.
Okay.
All right.
Love you.
I will. All right. Love you.
All right.